reception to our service today, and I want to thank God for the hour that we have. We are welcoming each and every one of you from your houses, together with your family, wherever you are seated, with your friends. And also you can share this online video so that everybody can get to hear a word this morning. There's somebody who comes from a church where there might not be such a service like a live stream that we're doing today. And therefore, when you invite somebody to this, you are actually telling somebody there is hope in Christ. And this message that I want to speak to you this morning, I want to talk about what do we do? What do we do in such situations? What are we required to do by the word of God when we have such situations? And I want you to look at the word of God, or into the word of God in the book of Psalms 50. This is where we're going to have the first sharing that we're going to do today in the name of Jesus Christ. And Psalms chapter 50 and beginning in verse number 4, 5. The Bible says, "Gather my sins together unto me, those that have made a covenant with me by sacrifice. And the heavens shall declare his righteousness, for God is judge himself. Hear, O my people, and I will speak, O Israel, and I will testify against you. I am God, even your God. I will not reprove you for your sacrifices or your burnt offerings to have been continually before. I will take no bullock out of your house, nor the he goats out of your folds. For every beast of the forest is mine, and the cattle upon a thousand hills. Praise the name of the Lord." Now, if you look at this word, and when God was ministering this word, alitumia maneno mazito sana. Akasema sita wananea jambo kuhusu dhabihu zenu na kafara ambazo mmenitolea. Lakini wakati Mungu alikuwa ananena na watu hao, hakunena maneno mazuri. Alinena kama kwa kukejeli. Alinena kama mwenye kuwatania fike katika jia fulani. He was mocking them actually. That concerning your sacrifices, I will not even speak about it. Oh, it has been continuing before me. And I think all of us would love such a statement that, oh God, so you have been seeing my sacrifices, so you have been seeing my offering. But the Lord is actually complaining, and he's saying unto the children of Israel, if I needed to eat, sita kuja kwenu nichukue ng'ombe zenu, sita kula pembeu zenu, hizo sio ambazo niko na haja nazo. Wapendwa, mahali tumefika, nataka kutangaza hii dunia, it has become so materialistic. People have drifted away from God. They have left the virtues, the real things that matter to God. Na watu wamejipeana katika vitu ambazo Mungu hana shughuli nazo. Nashukuru Mungu katika hili janga tunaweza kufundisha ya kwamba hii nyumba tumejenga ikatumia mamilioni ya pesa, lakini leo hakuna ibada hapa. I know there are beautiful cathedrals in this nation. Some were built by the colonialists, but there is no service today. Because God has become tired of our gathering. Gatherings that have no meaning. People who are just getting to church as a social gathering. It is a place where people are gathering in vain. Hakuna reason ya kuzanika. Watu wameenda tu waonekane. Wengine wameenda ili wajionyeshe. Wengine wameenda ili wasifiwe na watukuzwe. Wengine sisi ambao ni watungaji, watumishi wa Bwana, wengine tumeenda kwa sababu tukachukue sadaka, tukachukue kile ambacho tutapewa, tumekuja ili watu waone mambo haya yote Mungu amechoshwa nayo. Sisi sio wa kwanza, kulikuwa na watu wengine waliochosha Mungu. Akafika mahali akasema, hiyo mikusanyiko yenu mara sita kuja kwake. Sitaingia katika hizo nyumba. And I'm telling you brethren, the church must go back where it belongs. We must do what we are supposed to do in the name of Jesus Christ. Now, if you look at this, what he says, if I needed to eat, then the cattle on a thousand hills belong to me. Let me tell you, my friend, he materialism, mahali tumefika, na ulimwengu unaona vile umekoma, na ninaamini moja ya vitu ambavyo vinaashiria siku za mwisho, pengine katika nafasi nyingine ambayo ninapata ya kukuja kwako, nitawaendelea mambo mawili matatu kuhusu siku za mwisho na vile Mungu amesema. Lakini moja ya areas ambazo itagongwa siku za mwisho ni area ya economy. The reason people have trusted instead of trusting in God. People have believed in their jobs instead of believing in their God. People have believed in the world they have created for themselves instead of setting their faith in God. Look at the situation we are in. This is a virus, a very small thing, but it has shut down the airports of the world. It has shut down the systems of the world. What is going on? Because God is saying, I am tired of your things. I am tired of the things that you're doing. I am tired of what you are doing. Praise the name of the Lord. May God have mercy on us, church. May God have mercy on us, people. Wherever you are listening from, whether in your house, whether you are driving, whatever you are doing, I want to declare to you, this is the doing of the Lord. The church must go back to its original place in the name of Jesus Christ. And what is the original place of God? The place of humility. The place of understanding. We have nothing that we can do except by the grace of God. We have nothing we can do except by the power of the living God. Madawa ya kutengeneza. Madawa ya kufunguliwa. Watu wamepata madawa pia. Lakini ugonjwa umekuja ambao haujui hizo madawa. Ninatishangaa kwa dunia mzima. Infections zimefika, I think, over 80,000 people in the world today, as we speak, over 100,000 people. And one thing that we must understand, not even 100,000, is about 500,000 people right now, half a million people have been infected. Some with the high numbers. America really with over 100,000 people infected. But I want to ask you this question. The medicine world has been there for a long time. Madawa sisi tumegundua. Hata wakati Biblia inaongea katika kitabu cha Ezekiel 47, inasema ya kwamba kutakuwa na mto na kando yake kutakuwa miti na katika matawi yake kutakuwa uponyaji. Medicine was born even in the Bible times. But there is something that we must come to understand. We cannot just trust the medical science at the expense of trusting in God. Brethren, it is time for the church, it is time for the world to return to the living God. It is only the grace of God that can deliver us in the name of Jesus Christ. It is only God who can heal us. It is only God who can take us where we belong, my brother. Mahali wiko brother, ni wakati wa kunyenyekea. Ni wakati wa kukubali. Madawa yanawezeshia. Yamesimama. I was looking at these things and they are painful. They are pain in my heart. I don't know even how to speak about them. When you see places like Italy, one of the most developed countries in the world, a country that has been there for generations. When you see people in the hospital and they have no way, they have nothing that they can do. It is so painful to see people, elderly people die by thousands, by hundreds, just because there is no cure for this disease. My brother, my sister, it is time for us to humble ourselves before the Lord. It is time to consider our wickedness. And we must accept that we drifted away from God. We went away from the living God. We trusted the money. We trusted the resources. Tuliamini madawa. Tukakosa kumwamini Mungu. Bwana, naomba msamaha kuhusu jambo hili. Naomba msamaha katika kanisa lako. Naomba msamaha ya kwamba hata sisi watu wa imani tuliondoka kwako. Hatuogopi mambo. Hatufanyi mambo katika taratibu zinazopaswa kufanywa. Kwa sababu tuliweka imani katika madawa. Na Mungu ulisema, wakati misingi itatingizwa, mwenye haki atafanya nini? The foundations of medicine are shaken, oh God. There is nothing we can do. We cannot deliver ourselves. We can only trust in you, Jehovah God. Have mercy on us. In the name of Jesus Christ, and somebody say amen. May God have mercy on us as the nations of the world. May God have mercy on us as ministers. May God have mercy on us. It is not that I am criticizing. I am not in any way castigating the medical world. We thank God for the medical practitioners who are there. But I tell you the truth, in the world right now, and if God does not make an intervention, the medical world is overwhelmed. How are you? Hawajui wafanya nini. Madaktari wetu, they are not protected enough. Not only here in Kenya, but in other countries. And that's why I want to add every Kenyan. Even though you see us, you see me in the church, I am ministering. There are no people in the house. I just have a few people to organize this, the equipment so that you can have this message. I want you to hear them. It is not about time to keep on talking. Nilishanga, one of our members here was telling me the other day he was traveling in the matatu. Alafu wale watu wako kwa matatu mmoja anaambia mwingine, hii ugonjwa sisi wa Afrika gozi yetu ni ngumu, haiwezi kujia. Yaani huyu mtu nashindwa ni ujinga gani umefika kwa akili ya kwamba mtu haelewi hii ugonjwa haisababu. This is not a skin disease. It is a virus. It is an infection that can attack anybody. My brethren, when the government is saying keep a distance of at least 1 meter, do it, my brother. It is for your own good. It is for your own good. The medical world is overwhelmed. The governments are overwhelmed. The government of America is overwhelmed as we talk. The government of the UK, including the prime minister, is sick. So some two ministers are sick. One of the princes are sick. What are you talking about, my brother? It is time for us to understand. Even though the medical world is there, it is already overstretched. It is already overwhelmed. Hawajui watafanya nini na wewe. Hawajui ukiondoka watakupeleka wapi. Kwa sababu watu hospitali yetu ambayo ilitengwa Bagala, it is, has only 120 beds, you can imagine. Kenya is a country over 45 million people. My brother, it is good for you to understand. Out of 45 million people, if you are to get sick all of us, if even a quarter of the population was to get sick, where would we find the beds to take you to? It is time for us to look where we're supposed to look. It is time for us to face reality. It is time for us to tell the world that it is not as well as it seems. It is not as good as it looks from the eye. Father, I pray for the opening of the eyes of your people, for the opening of the hearts of your people, to understand that this is a dilemma we are facing together. And that, God, we need to be careful. We need to be men who are mindful. We need to be men who are conscious of these things, so that we do not bring trouble on ourselves. In the name of Jesus Christ, Lord, we thank you. Lord, we give you glory. Right now, my friends, the Bible says, I continue with the word of God. We are in the book of Psalms, chapter number 50. For those who are joining us live right now, we are in the book of Psalms, chapter number 50. And we have read from verse number 3. The Bible says in verse number 11, I know all the fowls by the mountains, and the wild beasts of the field are mine. If I be hungry, I will not tell you, for the world is mine, and the fullness thereof. I will eat, will I eat the flesh of bulls, or drink the blood of goats? Praise the name of the Lord. There is a sacrifice that God is looking for, not the sacrifice that people have given. I have people who cannot find time to seek God, but they have time to give God everything he wants. People who will help you with cannibals, but if you tell them pray, they will pray. People who can help you buy a machine in a single day. People who can even sow a seed of a kind in the church. But if you tell them to pray, they don't have the time, they don't have the ability. Oh, they will say they are very busy looking for the money to give unto God. God is not looking for money. All the gold, the Bible says somewhere in the book of Haggai that the silver and the gold belongs unto me, says the Lord. So I want you to understand, it is good for you to go seek out, get money, get wealth, as much as you can get it. I also do so. I also do the things that I can do. I also invest a little here and a little there. But I want you to know this. God is not interested in the physical needs. And that is what I'm saying. As you can see, we have an empty house today, an empty place of worship today. Because God is not interested in the physical material things that you can see. God is looking for something better, something bigger. The Bible says, for I do not dwell in a house built with the hands of men. Mungu hakai katika iliyojengwa na mikono ya watu. Mungu anatafuta hekalu ambao haikujengwa na mikono ya watu, haikufanywa na mikono ya watu. Anatafuta hekalu ambao haikujengwa na mikono ya watu. Anatafuta nyumba ambao haijajengwa na vitu vile watu wanafanya. Pesa zako ni nzuri, sadaka zako ni za maana. Hata sasa Baba tutakupea namba mahali unaweza sadaka yako, mahali ambapo leo tunatuma sadaka zetu mbele za Bwana. Lakini ni vizuri ujue sadaka hizi zote, they amount to nothing if the right kind of sacrifice is not given unto God. And therefore, I want us to go on in verse number 14. Sorry, the Bible says, offer unto God thanksgiving and put your ways unto the Most High. This is the sacrifice that God is looking for. Thanksgiving. Ni watu wangapi wako wanashukuru wakati tulikuwa tunatembea huko kila mahali? Ni watu wangapi tulikuwa tunashukuru ya kwamba tuna uhuru wa kuabudu? Ni watu wangapi ambao hatukuwa tunashukuru ya kwamba we can gather anytime, we can pray, we can speak to God, we can hear the word, we could have crusades. I remember just about 2 weeks ago, we were supposed to have a meeting here in Royal with Apostle John Kiman William, with the MBCIT, the Pastors Fellowship of this land of Ruiru and Kiambu. But that meeting had to be cancelled because it was in line with what the government said. We have been overlooking this thing. There was a time when we would put up our tents whenever we wanted. We would put up a crusade whenever we wanted. But we were very ungrateful. If great people have we been, may God help us to return to the place of thanksgiving, to offer a sacrifice of thanksgiving to God. I have to say this, Kenyans right now, wherever you are, wherever you are watching, hearing me from, I want to say, Kenya, let us be grateful. We are not like China. We are not like America. We are not like Britain. We are not like Italy. We are not as developed as Germany. We are not as developed as France. We are not as the Spanish people. They have the best infrastructure in the world in terms of some of the medical facilities. But today, if an individual needed an operation, there is no room, there is no way for you to go to China, to go to India, to go to South Africa. Even if you are given a free ticket today, there is no way for you to go to the places where you would want to go, for one reason, that this is not a joke. The sickness, the ailment has destroyed the infrastructures of the world. My friends, let us be grateful that though Kenya, we are not as prepared as other nations. We are not as good as other nations. We have been preserved this far. That although we don't have the medical facilities that other worlds have, we are not as they are, but we are where we are because of the grace of the living God. We are where we are because of the grace of the living God. Wakati tulikuwa na pesa, tunaenda hoteli ile tunataka, tunaenda kula kile tunataka. Mioyo yetu haiko kushukuru Bwana kwa sababu hatuona kama ni jambo kubwa, lakini ni wakati wa kureflect na kusema kwamba Mungu hatukushukuru. Tulipokuwa tunasafiri bila tunataka, tunakaa kwa matatu mpaka tunaongea mastori kule, tunakaa kwa mabasi tukisafiri, trains zilikuwa zinatubeba, ndege zilikuwa zinatubeba, and it is over. About a week ago, not even a week ago, 3 days ago, I was supposed to travel, we were supposed to travel out of Kenya, but here I am, growing. For this reason, that this thing has affected me. There were safaris that were planned for me in the year, but I'm not even sure whether I will be traveling. Why? Because the situation is not as it was. But when the planes were flying over my house every day, oh, my friends, may God have mercy on us. It is now that I'm remembering. For about 3 days, I've not had aircraft pass over my roof. Otherwise, my house is under one of the airways whereby the planes pass in droves. But I've not had a plane for the last 3 days. My brother, my sister, because the situation is not good, I was not appreciating that God, you allow us to fly where we want. You allow us to go where we want. We want to where you allow us to move freely as we go. I was not grateful. Wapendwa, nataka mahali uliko inua mikono kwanza, tuambie Bwana tusamehe ya kwamba hatukumshukuru. Na walio pamoja nasi hivyo, walio pamoja nami hapa, tuinue mikono tuambie Bwana, tusamehe kama taifa, tusamehe kama watu ya kwamba hatukukushukuru hata wakati mambo yalikuwa mazuri, wakati mambo yalikwenda vyema. We were ungrateful, my God. We never thought that it was important. We never thought that walking around freely without minding who is touching who, it was not a big deal to us. But God, we accept that
But oh God, in the name of the Lord, have mercy on us in the name of the Lord. Have mercy on us in the name of the Lord. Have mercy on us, our Father. Have mercy on us, Jehovah. Oh God, we are ungrateful. We are ungrateful. But today we take the opportunity to give thanks unto you. To kuona kipamoja uwambie Bwana asante. Asante kwa baraka zile umetupea. Asante kwa sababu ya mahali umetufikisha. Asante kwa neema ile ambayo tumefikiwa nayo. Asante kwa ushindi ambao tumefikiwa nao. Asante kwa utukufu ambao umetufikia. Asante kwa neema ambao tumeona. Asante kwa baraka ambazo zimetufikia Bwana. May your name be glorified. May your name be exalted, Jehovah. Reka sola baganda. Rapo sala bazambi. Oh God, we were very ungrateful. Ingrate people who could not be trusted by God. But we come to you as that man who came to you. And oh God, say, I was healed. Therefore I returned. We don't want to be like the nine who never came back. But we want to be like the one who came and said thank you. We want to be like the one who came and said, surely this is the doing of the Lord. We thank you, we worship you. We give you glory because you're mighty, our Father. May your name be exalted. May your name be magnified, our Father. Right now we pray, receive our thanksgiving, my Father. Receive our thanksgiving, my God. Receive our praise, our Father. In the name of the Lord, we worship you. We magnify your name because you're worthy. Because unto you belong the honor, belong the glory, now and forevermore. And somebody say, amen. Amen. And we continue with the word of God because our time is still running out. The Bible says in verse 14 says, offer thanksgiving unto God and your ways unto the Lord. So I want us to understand. And the other sacrifice that we can give is to align our ways unto the Lord. Kurejesha njia zetu kwa Bwana. Kutojiongoza. Na katika hii dunia watu ambao tuko twajiongoza, twajipeleka kule tunaona ni kuzuri, twajipeleka kule tunafikiri ni kuzuri, twafanya mambo yale ambayo tunaona kama ni mazuri, kama ni makubwa, ndio mambo ambayo yametupendeza, yametushika. Lakini kuna mambo Mungu anatafuta katikati yetu, kuna mambo Mungu anataka tuyaelewe katikati yetu. So as we continue with the word of God, I want you to hear verse 15. And call upon me in the day of trouble, I will deliver you, and you shall glorify. The Bible says, call unto me in the day of trouble. So this is another thing that I want you to know, church. Wherever you are gathered, wherever you are watching us from, I want to declare to you this day that we are given room to watch in the presence of God. We are given room to seek in the presence of the Lord. Hallelujah. We are given room to talk to God, even in our trouble. We have the room to hear from the presence of God. We have the room to understand what the Lord is saying as we talk to him this morning, as we cry unto him this day. For he said, call unto me, and I will answer in the day of trouble. Ni shida gani tuko nayo, kama hii ambayo tuko nayo, janga hili ambalo tuko nayo, tunaweza simama, tunaweza litia jina la Bwana, tunaweza mwambia Bwana tusamehe, tunaweza mwambia Bwana tusamehe, tunaweza lakini ulisema siku ya shida tukuite. Kuna neno nafikiri, praise the name of the Lord, hallelujah, linalosema ya kwamba the Lord is a present help in the day of trouble. A present help ni msaada wa karibu katika siku ya shida. Hallelujah. Yeye ni msaada wa karibu, ni msaada ambao unaweza fikiwa katika wakati wa shida. Na kwa hivyo katika hili neno ni vizuri uweke moyoni mwako ya kwamba he will say, I am a present help. He will be a helper unto us in the name of the Lord.
faith in the name of the Lord. And therefore, as we call on the name of the Lord, it is good for us to understand He who said, I will be a helper in the day of trouble, shall be our helper even now. As we call upon the name of the Lord, as we call on the name of the living God, He will be our helper. Hallelujah. He will be our helper in these times of need in the name of the Lord. There is a river that flows from the mountain of the Lord, and it carries the healing. It brings the joy into the city. Praise the name of the Lord. And therefore, as we continue, I want you to trust in the mercies of God. We can call the name of the Lord in our day of trouble. Tunaweza litia jina la Bwana. Ni kweli kuna shida, ni kweli kuna matatizo, ni kweli kuna mambo hayaendi vizuri, lakini Bwana Mungu atakuwa msaada wetu katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Praise the name of the Lord. Psalm 46 verse number 4. There is a river that the streams there shall make glad the city of God, the holy place of the tabernacles of the Most High. Oh, praise the name of the Lord. The Lord of hosts is with us. The Lord of hosts is with us. Verse number 1, God is our refuge and strength, a very present help in trouble. Musaada wa karibu wakati kuna matatizo. Amesema tuliitie jina lake na yeye atakusikia. Kwa hivyo katika hizi hali ambazo tumefikia mpendwa, one of the other things that we must teach ourselves to do is to pray, is to speak to God, is to talk to God in our condition. Though we be pressed down, though things are not working right, though things are not the way they are supposed to be, but we can have an assurance as we talk to God, as we cry unto the living God, we can call upon Him and He will answer us. The Bible says, call upon me in the day of trouble and I will deliver you and you shall glorify me. The other thing that we must learn to do is to glorify the Lord. Kumutukuza Bwana katika mambo haya yote. Na ninajua kwamba vinywa vya watu wengi vimejaa manung'uniko. Vinywa vya watu wengi vimejaa makelele wakati kama huu. Vinywa vya watu wengi vinaongea kuhusu tu mabaya, kuhusu tumefanyiwa, kukefanywa, fulani angefanya, China ndio ilituletea. I want you to know this for sure and for free. It is only God who can deliver us. It is only God who can heal us. We can only set our minds on God. We can only set our faith on God. We can only set our faith in God and trust that He who did to others before will do it unto us in the name of the Lord. As we continue in today's service, I want you to have time to lift up glory unto the Lord, to glorify the Lord. Lift up your voice wherever you are and just glorify the living God. Lift up your voice wherever you are and exalt the name of the Father, the name of the one who has the coronavirus in his hands. Hakuna kitu kimemshinda. Wacha tuombe utukufu. Alisema nitakapoinuliwa nitajivutia mataifa yote kwangu. Alisema nitakapoinuliwa nitajivutia mataifa yote kwangu. Wacha tumuinue, wacha tumtukuze siku ya leo. Wacha tumwambie kwamba anastahili hata katika hali hii, hata wakati tuna hii virus na inatembea katika dunia na inaharibu katika dunia. Oh my God, I can say that for sure, our God, you are the Lord, you are a faithful God, you deserve the glory, that even in the things that we are facing, you are still our God, that even in our situation, you are God, in our situations, in our conditions, you are God, in our conditions, you are the Lord, you in our situation, when we have that pain in our hearts, when we have been going through what we have been going through, you are God, and you deserve the glory, you deserve the honor, you deserve the praises of our God, that though we are troubled on every side, though we are crushed by God, we will not be broken. We have the presence of God together with us, we have the grace of God together with us, we have the life and the mercies of God upon us, and the things will be beautiful in the presence of the Lord. I thank you because you are God. I thank you because you are God. I thank you because you are God. I lift up your name and give you glory because you are worthy. You receive the glory.
you receive the glory.
As you take care of yourself, I pray that the grace of God will cover you. The power of God will cover you. My friend, according to the word of God, there are scandals that will come in this world. There are floods that will come in this world. But the Bible says, I will preserve the righteous. I will preserve my people. Na nataka asubuhi ya leo ujiandae. In about 30 minutes, I will be back with another word. Na nataka to share on the word of God that kulingana na siku za mwisho, Mungu atafanya nini na sisi tunastahili kufanya nini. Mambo haya ni mambo ambayo yatakuja, haya yafika. Biblia inasema wakati utasikia magonjwa ambayo haina madawa, wakati utasikia watu wameteseka, hawana njia, ujue kwamba ni mwanzo. Kwa hivyo haya mambo ndio yameanza, hata hayajafika. Kuna mambo ambayo yatakuja. Kuna mtu mmoja leo asubuhi alikuwa ananikumbusha ati kwamba miaka 20 na kitu wakati nilikuwa nahubiri mahali pamoja, nikaambia watu ya kwamba kuna wakati utakuja na magonjwa yatatokea na watu hawataona haja ya kuwa kanisani, hawatafika kwa ibada. Miaka hiyo ilipita, miaka kama 22 imepita. Ujumbe huo niliyounena, I wish there were recording devices at that time because there were no recording devices, but I want you to understand this. Even in that evil situation, Mungu alitupea neno, na katika neno lile limetufanya tuwe watu ambao tumesimama. Saa hizi tunapokumbana na haya, hatuoni mazito, tunakumbuka kuna neno Mungu alinena. Kwa hivyo hapa sasa kuna majanga mengine yatakuja, kuna mapigo mengine ambayo yatakuja, lakini tumefika wapi na tutafanya nini kama kanisa? Na wakati tunaingia katika maombi, kama unataka kutoa sadaka yako katika ibada hii, unaweza toa kupitia nambari ya simu ambao utakupea 0719 72 7770, 0719 72 7770. Samahani kwamba wale ambao pengine walikuwa wamesoma pale imeandikwa vibaya, kuna 71 ambao haipo. Kwa hivyo nitarudia tena, 0719 72 7770, that is 0719 72 7770, that is the official church line that you can use, and that you can give your offering through by the grace of God and according to the grace that God has given you. Remember, even in this shutdown, the church still needs to run, and the church still continues, and the work the Lord has given unto us, we will continue to do according to the grace that God has given us. So the line is open, you can give your offering in the presence of the Lord, and we are praying for you. May the Lord preserve you. May the Lord prosper your seed. May the Lord cause you to become a great man and a great woman in this land. May the scourge that has come not touch you. Biblia inasema Daudi, Danieli alitupwa katika tundu la simba. Na alipotupwa katika tundu la simba, Daniel, may the God you serve preserve. And the Bible says in the morning, because the king could not sleep, very early in the morning, he went to where Daniel had been thrown into the pit. And the Bible says he called out and said, Daniel, has the Lord your God whom you serve continually delivered you? And Daniel answered and said, sure, my king, the Lord has preserved me. So even now, the Lord who preserved Daniel is the same yesterday, today, and forever. He will preserve you. Don't be careless, don't be reckless as you do your things. Even here, I am careful. Even in the church, you put up the measures that are necessary. But I want you to know this, in all these things, the Lord will deliver. The Lord will preserve. Father, we thank you for your people who are watching us online and the few who are gathered here for the purposes of life streaming this service. Oh God, this is our prayer. Deliver us from the scourge of this coronavirus in the name of the Lord. Deliver us in the name of Jesus. Oh God of our preservation, we were not preserved at any given time because of our money, neither because of our health infrastructure, neither because of the medical practitioner, but we were preserved because the Lord was together with us. And this is what we are doing today, agreeing and accepting the responsibility here, that the Lord, we drifted away from you. Instead of becoming grateful for what you have done, we became ingrate, our God. But this day we declare, receive the glory. It is you who has done it unto us. Ni wewe umetubariki, ni wewe afya yetu, ni wewe umetupatia neema ile tuko nayo, ni wewe umetupea.
upe utukufu kwa maana wewe ni mwema. Ninaomba ya kwamba neema na kibali chako zitazidi kuwa juu yetu na nguvu zako zitazidi kuwa juu yetu kwa sababu wewe ni mwaminifu na hakuna mwingine kama wewe. Dakika hii tunaomba ya kwamba Mungu wa mbinguni ulisema tumuite siku ya shida na utatusikia, utatuponya. Na siku aliitia jina lako, heal us O God, deliver us in the name of the Lord, save us our Father, the God who preserved Daniel, preserve us our Father, the God who preserved Joseph, preserve us our Lord. Take care of us, watch over us in the name of the Lord. Father, we pray for those who are watching us online, for those who are listening from their homes. We decree the word of God upon them, the favor of God upon them, and the power of the living God to be upon them in a great way. Father, preserve us and watch over us. We pray that those who are offering their offerings, O God, that have already started being given in the house of the Lord and through online payments, O God, we pray that, Father, you will bless them, you will increase them, and their sacrifices come as a memorial before you in their days and in their times. So we honor you and we praise you because you're worthy. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior, do we pray and do we give thanks.
Amen.
Amen and amen. And as we wind up our service, I would like to shut the service without maybe giving occasion to somebody. You might be there, you are a sinner, or you have been living a sinful life and you want to return to the Lord. Can you just lift up your hand and pray together with me by faith and say, Dear Lord, I come to you. I am a sinner, unworthy before you, but I ask today, forgive me, wash me clean, deliver me from my uncleanness, from my unfaithfulness, and save me, my Lord. Thank you for salvation. Thank you for your forgiveness. I receive mercy. I receive your favor. And I declare I am a new creature. Give me the Holy Spirit to be my teacher, to teach me on the pathway that I must walk the rest of my life. In the name of Jesus, do I pray and do I believe. Amen and amen. And finally, I want to ask, if you have a problem and you feel that you need to pray together, believing God, the Bible says in the book of Matthew chapter 18 from verse number 18, whatever two people shall ask, whatever they shall buy, shall be bound, whatever they use, shall be used. And the Bible also continues to say in the verses below that, whatever they agree, two of you agree and pray, it shall be given unto them. So as we make our argument in prayer, we believe that God shall hear you. Wherever you are, ukiwa kwa nyumba yako, Mungu atakuponya. Ukiwa kwa nyumba yako, Mungu atakukumbuka. Mungu atakubariki kwa sababu yeye ni mwaminifu. Na tuombe, nyosha mkono wako katika jina la Kristo na nena hili neno katika maisha ya watu wako. Uponyaji na nguvu katika maisha yao katika jina la Yesu. Nguvu za wokovu na ukombozi juu ya maisha yao. Natangaza nguvu ya uponyaji, magonjwa yakaondoke katika jamaa zao. Magonjwa yaondoke katika miili yao. Wale ambao wamesekwa na shetani wafunguliwe. Bwana Mungu, kila mtu anayehitaji divine intervention, wengine kwa sababu ya hali hii ya ugonjwa huu hawana kazi za kufanya, hawana mapato, lakini Mungu wa miujiza, wewe uliyetuma kunguru wakalisha Elijah, na utume kunguru wako walishe watu wako, na kuwe na njia za watu kufanikiwa na kubarikiwa, kwa maana wewe ni mwaminifu. Tunakupenda, tunakuinua kwa sababu umesikia maombi yetu katika jina la Yesu Kristo. Bwana wetu tuomba na hata kuamini. Amen. And from this altar, we want to decree the blessings of God to you, to each and every one of you who has been watching us live, and even those who will watch later on. We want to thank God for you. I want to say, for those maybe you joined us and wanted to give your offering, even the members of the church, and for those who belong to other congregations, you can send your offerings through the official means that is supposed to be sent in the congregation or where you come from. You are comfortable sending today into this altar, we thank God for you. So 0719-727770 is our number. 0719-727770. Ndio nambari ambayo unaweza tumia
ya kujitolea matoleo yako, sadaka yako inakubalika mbele za Bwana. Bwana awabariki. Shalom. Tuonane wale ambao wanaweza. In 30 minutes we shall have another broadcast. Amen.